Just Outdoors is brought to you in part by the following community supporters.
Jervelin Hardware Hank, Deer River. Jervelin Hardware offers a broad selection of paints and sporting goods and a complete line of plumbing and electrical supplies. Jervelin Hardware, 108 Main Avenue, Deer River.
Meds One Emergency Medical Services. Meds One provides mobile advanced life support, community paramedic primary care services, and education, event medical support, and consulting. Preserving lives and improving health. In an emergency, always call 911.
This program is sponsored in part by Brood Awakenings Coffee House. Brood Awakenings is a green business with the mission to be a cafe where a person can eat every day and be healthy. Nurture your inner being at Brood Awakenings, downtown Grand Rapids on Highway 2 East, across from the courthouse.
Hi, my name is Tom Chapin, and welcome to Itasca Community Television's Just Outdoors. Today, we're going to be doing a little backwoods pan fishing for perch, winter pan fishing for perch. And what we're going to do is we're going to go in on some U.S. Forest Service, Chippewa National Forest Service roads. We're going to go in off the main road about 7 to 8 miles. We're going to go into a very remote lake and we're going to fish perch today. And for those that have never done this, it's a great chance to take a look and see how to fish perch in the wintertime. We're going to be very basic. It's going to be perch fishing 101. And we're going to be going in on these roads. We're going to have to four-wheel drive in another 2 miles off this particular road that we're on. And once we get in there, we're going to be setting up a house. We're going to show you how to set up a house. We're going to drill some holes. We've got about 2 feet of ice. Today it's about 5 degrees right now, so it's a fairly cold day, but yet there's not a lot of wind. And the wind is the thing that really bothers you out here when you're ice fishing. But today looks like a pretty nice day. Whether the fish are going to bite or not, it's really tough to tell. And it is for any fisherman that goes out, you never really know. But perch are one of the best eating fish you can find. And the limit on them is 20. And we have 4 people with us today, so we're going to give it a shot. As far as how we do, we're going to use all kinds of different baits. But the main thing is we're going to be going into a very remote lake. And this lake is probably 7 to 8 miles from any residence. It's about an 800-acre lake. It also has northern pike. And so we're going to set up some tip-ups while we're fishing with some sucker minnows for northern pike also. And it's going to be a good day. We're going to show you how to do this. And as we go in, we'll show you some of the remote road that we're taking. And once we get on the lake, we'll set everything up and let you look at the equipment we use and all the fishing lures and just how we do this. Okay, here we go. We're going down the road that's going into the lake. It's another couple miles into this remote lake in Chippewa National Forest, and they have a lot of lakes like this around. This is probably about a, well, I don't know, 700 to 800 acre lake, but it's a shallower lake. It's got, again, perch, crappies, northern pike, and you know, when you do this, it's something to do in the winter. It's this time of the year where you don't see a lot of other folks in here, especially these remote lakes, because it is tougher to get in. But the reason we're driving in here right now at this time of year in January is that it's a lack of snow. You can see there's very little snow compared to most years, particularly last year, 2014, when it was just, you could not get in here at all, hardly even with a snowmobile. It was tough. And normally we snowmobile into this lake to catch perch, but today, and why we chose today is we can drive in. We can actually drive in. We're bringing a trailer with us with all our equipment. And it's so much easier to do that, of course, but we'd be doing this on snowmobiles this time, even if there was a lot of snow, because we just have some pretty good success back here most of the time. And again, the perch is one of the better fish to eat. You're allowed 20, and if we come out of here with, you know, the maximum would be 80 perch, we've gone in here also when the perch haven't bit. And so there are times when you might come in and only get 5 or 6. So we're kind of looking forward to see what the bite is like and if it's on today. So here we go. We're going down this forest road. We got another mile and a half before we get to the lake. And once we get on in the lake, we'll show you the entire lake. They'll show you just exactly what the shoreline is and how and where we're going to set up. Okay, we've arrived at the lake. We got some holes getting cut here. And the first hole we cut was about where we want to put the house. We got about 13 feet of ice here. 13 feet of water, about 2 feet of ice. And so this is kind of where we're going to want to set up. And maybe we'll pan part of the lake here to show you just how remote this is. It's quite a lake that's really back in the woods. That's why we're calling this backwoods perch fishing, winter perch fishing. And it's a lake that is fairly inaccessible in the wintertime, unless you know where it is and know how to get in with a lot of snow, which we normally have. It's a pretty tough lake. So here we are. We're here, and I'm going to clean off this area. Our house is about 11 feet wide. It holds 4 people really efficiently for fishing. In fact, each person in the house can have 2 holes. That's how big it is. So I'll be shoveling some of this area around this hole. And what we're going to do when we set this house up, we're going to set the house up first, and then mark where the house is going to be, and then drill the holes, and then set the house over the top of the holes. And then once you do that, then we're going to anchor the house down so the wind won't blow us away. They're really susceptible to wind, these lighthouses. We got a wind out of the southeast today. Not a lot of wind. It's probably about 8 to 10 miles an hour, but that's enough to really move the house. So you really have to anchor it down. Even with that little amount of wind, you still got to anchor it. And so that's what we're going to do. We're going to be shoveling an area off here, setting the house up, moving the house off, drilling the holes, and putting the house back up, and then we'll anchor it. Okay, we're to the point of setting up this house. It's a clam model house. It's about 11 feet wide. It's the biggest one they make that's not insulated. So we got to have a pretty good heater in there. It's cold out here right now. There's about 10 to 15 mile an hour wind, and we can really feel it. So we're looking forward to getting in that house. And Roger and I are going to try to set this up. It goes up pretty simple. And so we'll show you how to do this. It's simple enough if there's no wind. There's a little wind today, so we might have this thing flying away from us. But once we get the anchors down, we'll be fine. So, Roger, we're going to just grab the opposite ends here, and then we're just going to pull and open that up. Okay. Now we're going to move around. We're going to do the same thing to the opposite side. Is that out, Raj? Here you go. You got to pull it out. There we go. Okay. Now we're going to do the opposite side here, which is right on this one. And we just pull out. Kind of hard to get a hold of them. All right, good. Do the same with the last two. There's 6 sides that have to go up here. And once we get this out, we're good to go there. And if you want to come over here, I'll show you what to do on the inside. We're going to have to push the top up. And there it is. And if you want to take a peek in here, You can see the room that we have, and we're going to be setting up probably 4 to 6 holes right inside here. We'll set a heater in here, put some chairs in here, and we'll be nice and toasty comfy within about 15 minutes after we get everything set up and get this thing anchored down. And we'll show you how to anchor it down here in just a minute. Okay, we got one of our individuals out here, Len Daigle. And Len is cutting holes, and we're cutting the holes where we marked them when we had the house on here. We're gonna move the house back on the holes, but he's cutting the last hole. Go ahead, Len. And again, we're cutting through about 2 feet of ice, and then we'll clear all this off, clear all the holes out. And once we clear the holes, we'll set the house back on top. And then we'll bring in our heater, and we'll anchor the house down. We'll show you how we anchor it here the next round here. So now we got the holes drilled. We're just about halfway through this little venture. Okay, we're gonna anchor this fish house down now to the lake because into the ice because it's windy out, and we need to have this thing anchored, otherwise it'll blow away. We've got everything cleared off inside. We got about 7 holes drilled inside here, and we've already anchored down the 5 out of the 6 anchors that hold it down on the inside. We're also putting snow around the outside on some flaps that go out that kind of help hold it down too and stops the wind from coming in underneath. But here's what we use to anchor. Here's the actual anchor right here we're going to use, and then this is a device you can attach to your drill, and you just have a drill with a battery. You should want to bring a good battery because it does take a lot of power to put these in. And what we do is we just put this into the drill and we tighten it up, and then we take the anchor itself, put it in this holder, and it's ready to go. And this is very efficient. All we do is just, here's the strap that we are going to attach the anchor to. And what we do is, well, first of all, you got to have that tight. Make sure that's tight. We'll get that down. There it is. Okay, we're going to drill right down here, right by the strap that holds this side down. I'm going to drill down. That's all it takes right there. That is in there, good and tight. And we take this strap, we place it around the anchor, then we pull the strap tight, and that's not going anywhere. This will hold this whole side down right here. No wind's gonna take that away from you. We also have anchors we can put on the outside in a big wind where we can attach ropes to the anchors against the wind. So if we ever get some big wind, you can always attach it from the outside too. And another thing we have in here is we have some hooks here that you can hang your clothes, hang some of your fishing gear, your hats all around here, and that kind of keeps it, keeps them out of the way, off the ice, and keeps them fairly warm. And then we also want to, since we're using propane in here, a propane sunflower heater, we're gonna want vents open. And we open all the vents. Here are the vents right here. They close up, but you just have them open. And that also not only gives you a good fresh airflow, but it also keeps a lot of the moisture out that's gonna build up from the burning of the propane here. And so that's what you wanna do. You wanna keep everything safe. And even with the vents open, you're gonna be able to get it up with that propane heater on a day like this. It's 5 above 0. You'll have it 50 to 60 degrees in here, no problem. And so from now here, we're gonna go on to getting our fishing gear and showing you some of the jigs we're gonna be using. We're pretty well set up to fish here. It takes a little while to get set up, especially with the wind. The wind came up a little more after we initially set the house up and cut the holes. And so we had to put a couple anchors here down to the ice just to hold the sides from collapsing from the windward side. The other side you don't need it, but just on the windward side. That'll make it good and secure. So as we go around the house, Roger took some snow and we kind of banked it around here all the way around, and you can see that it's really solid. That keeps the air from coming in from underneath. And it's going to be nice and cozy in there. We already got the heater going. We'll show you that. We put that in the center. And as we come around, you can see that you do have to have a license on these houses if you're going to keep them overnight. And if you don't have them overnight, you don't need a license for this, but you do need your name on them at all times or your driver's license number. So what we have on there is a driver's license number right there, and that's how I put it on that, and that's sufficient. It's now legal. And as we walk around, this is about 11 and a half feet wide. It can accommodate actually up to about 6 fishermen. We've got 4 today. And one thing we did is a couple of the guys already set up some tip-ups. And we have one tip-up set up about 120 feet from the house. And that's for northern pike. So we'll be watching that regularly through the windows of this house. There's 6 windows in the house, so we can see outside. It lets a lot of light in. And on a day like this, let me tell you, a house like this is just almost essential if you're going to spend the day out. And for perch, it takes a while to catch your 20 perch, because you're going to catch a lot of small ones. You're throwing those back, probably keeping the bigger ones. In this lake, they run from 8 to about 10 inches. This is the ones we keep. Not many more over that. They aren't huge perch, but they're very, very edible. So as we're coming around here, I want you to come in here and take a look inside to see where we got the chairs set up and the heater. Just kind of open this like this and kind of take a peek around there if you can. Kind of tough with the camera to get inside like that, but that's what we're going to do. We're going to be all set up here. We got chairs, and eventually we got lunch. You want to bring a lunch when you're going out a day like this, because you're always out a lot longer than you think you're going to be. I was figuring we'd be done by 3, but we're probably going to be out until sunset today. So that's how we're set up here. And now we're going to go fishing. We're going to catch some fish. I'll show you some of the jigs later that we're using when we get inside here. And we'll start up the fishing. We have a tip-up that went off, a flag up. And it happens to be Rogers. And we haven't even started fishing in the house yet. We're just getting going with the perch fishing, and all of a sudden one of the tip-ups goes off. This is the one that we set up earlier. So let's go over and see what he might have here. You can see it going around there, a little bit of ice on top, but that camera should pick up the line. Now it stopped, now it's still going. So there's definitely something on there. It's probably not a perch, it's probably a northern. There's all size northerns in this lake. You never know what you're gonna catch. So it could be a what they call a hammer handle, a little under a pound and a half, or it could be a bigger fish. So we'll let the master take over here.
Big thing is when you're fishing the tip up, you wanna put the tip up here and then throw your line downwind.
Exactly.
Tangle it up.
Otherwise it's gonna tangle all up. So that's a good point. And you got to kind of set the hook a little bit on these sometimes. You're not real hard, but now he's got it on.
Whatever it is, it's small.
It's very small. Just tell by it, but it took a little line out though. You can see that it was only 13 feet deep here, and he's already got 25 feet of line out. So up it comes. Small fish, it'll probably go back in, but still fun. No, it's still going down. You don't want to pull too hard on them, especially when you get them up around the bottom of the ice. That's when they get off. And if they start running, just give them line. That's a small fish. That's a small northern. So that's what, in 5 years, that'll be catchable. Hopefully. Down it goes. Very good. Okay, we have another tip up off here. We're having a hard time getting fishing in the house because we got tip ups gone off. We had one over here and broke the line. And this one is again Rogers, and we're going to take a look and see what he's got. And the reason we got the carpet on there really works good. That keeps the hole open. You hardly ever have to clean the ice out, no matter what the temperature. you put a little bit of carpet on. And we're checking here and nothing's going, yeah, it's going around still. So there's definitely a fish on. You never know. That's what's nice about tip-up fishing, is that you just never know what you're going to get. And as far as this lake, you know, you never know the size either. So let's try it again. This is the third one we've had on now. What size do you feel there, Roger? Medium, small?
It's bigger than the last one, I think. But it's,
well,
it's
a lot of fish are bigger than the last one.
Yeah, it's a small fish.
Okay. But I tell you, it's cold out here. It's windy and it's cold. So you don't want to be out here too long. And here we go. Boy, he took a lot of line out. Probably, we're up to probably 30 feet of line so far. And there's the, okay, I just saw the, I didn't see the fish, but I saw the leader that's hooked onto the hook that's hooked onto the fish. So up we come. And this is the third one we've had on now. We caught a small one, we lost one that broke the line, and now this one. And this is all within about 15 to 20 minutes here. Now he's letting it take line. And we'll just keep on it here. That's what we do. And as far as I'm concerned, northern pike are a very edible fish. Depends on how you clean them and how you get the bones out. There it is. Okay, that's a couple pounds. That'll probably be a fish that we'll keep, because there's a couple of us that know of people in Grand Rapids that like fish. They don't get to fish. They don't get to fish at all. And they enjoy eating fish, whether it's northern pike or any other fish. So this is probably going to go to somebody that is in need of some fish that they haven't had in a while. Good job, Rudder. All right, now we're walking back to our house. We're like one of the tip-ups that Roger just caught that fish. He was about 100 feet away. So we're walking back to the house, and you can see that we drove out here, we set this up, and normally this time of year, very rare that you can drive out here. That's why we're out here. We're taking advantage of this weather. Not real cold, cold enough to have to have a house, but yet not as much snow as we usually have. We can drive out on these lakes now. It's a perfect fishing conditions right now. This happens to be the one I set out here about a half an hour ago. So there's a fish taking this down. It's just, it's really swirling. Some folks like to let it run until it's done running, or it stops running. I tend to like to take it when it's moving. So yeah, we got a fish on. Not very big, but it's something that you really can't tell. Oh, I think we lost it. It came off. We lost that one, Leo. We're gonna take a look and see if the minnow's still there. Took a lot of line. Well, we're caught on the bottom there. Okay. All right, we're, looks like we're caught on the bottom of the ice. So we'll take care of that problem later. But we missed one here. Okay, we haven't talked much about the type of equipment to catch perch. It sure doesn't take much. It doesn't take a lot of money to get involved in this sport. Just a reel, a winter reel, just a small panfish reel, a small panfish rod, got a lot of flex, and 4 pound test line at the most is what you want to use. Some people use 2 or 3, 4 pound probably the most. You can use a bobber to hold your bait up and jig it in the hole, or you can just use a plain jig. Really doesn't matter. Most perch are caught right on the bottom. You want to be right close to the bottom of the lake. Here's a, what they call a Swedish pimple. It's got a treble hook on it. That's a very small Swedish pimple. It's very conducive to catching fish at this time of the year. It's pretty much strictly an ice fishing jig. Pretty heavy. It'll go down to the bottom real fast. You can tip it with a head of a minnow or a whole minnow, and it flashes down there, and you're also going to get a few northern pike on this too. They're going to be attracted. And so here's the basic rig. You can also use a jig, just a regular jig. I got some jigs here that I'll show you, and they're pretty small, but these are number 10, number 12, number 14 jigs. There's a lot of small ones in there, and this is really all you need. These are kind of neat because these are actually tungsten. They're heavy and they go down real quick. They got a real small hook, so you gotta, when you hook the fish, you gotta pull them up pretty quick. And that's about all you need right there. Just small jigs, a couple light reels, a couple light rods, and you're good to go for perch fishing. This is all we're using today, so we'll see what happens. We got about a half a dozen fish so far, and we'll show you a few of our catches when the lines go down. We'll bring up a few fish for you. Fish the hole here inside the house. Get a, hard to tell what it is. Is it a northern?
It's a northern.
It's a northern.
But I think we're going to have to, Tom, you want to come down here and you might have to.
Sure, I can go in after it.
To me,
sure.
I have too light a line to try to bring.
Yes, yeah, we got 4-pound line with a northern. It's pretty tough. Oh yeah, there's a, it's not too bad either. No, don't let them go. We don't want to bring them out of the water.
Okay.
There we go. Not too bad of a fish. 2.5 pounds or so. About like the other one. This is probably going to go to an individual in Grand Rapids that needs some fish. And it sounds like we got another one going on the outside.
Okay, I'll take care of this.
Okay, and it swallowed the hook. Work. Thank you. Fish in the house there. We got another one on here, but it doesn't look like it's moving. That doesn't mean anything a lot of the times. When this isn't moving, there still could be a fish on. And it seems like I feel something down there. But we'll check it out. Oh, I see why. The line is wrapped around here. And there is a fish on. And it doesn't feel real big, but you know, you just go with what you got. It's a small one. I see it and it got off. Came right up in the hole and I'm glad it got off. It was only about that long. So what we'll do is we'll check the minnow. And looks like it's okay. And what we're using is just a single hook. It's a small leader. It's a snelled hook, meaning there's a leader attached to the hook. It's about 35, 40 pound test line. And we just tie that right onto the line. And that's about all there is. We'll put it right back down. See what happens. Well, we got one running here again. We're not doing too good on perch today, more northerns than anything. And you can see the fish taking that one. And we got another one over here, Leo. We got, we'll talk about that later, but there's another flag up. So the northerns are running today, but the perch don't seem to be going too good. Oh, he's just buzzing that. Just taking line. I'm going to stop him like this. There we go. He got off. So taking a lot of line, but he did get off. We'll try it again. They'll do that. And boy, he was really taking it out. That felt like a bigger fish when I pulled on it. It felt like it was, over 3 pounds for sure. Hard to tell ever, but you can see how much line went out. And he got the minnow, of course, too. So we'll have to rebait on that one. And we'll put another minnow on and put him down again. Inside the fish, I was fishing for perch. I can see him down there, about the same size as the other ones. Maybe a little smaller, no, about the same size. I'm gonna help him out here because got such light line, they'll bite off pretty quick. You know? Don't want to put any weight on him or pressure, not much pressure. You probably got about a pound to 2 pounds pressure on there. That's all you want to do.
He's coming up now, Tom.
Coming up, now just grab him. Whoops. He's a smaller one. We don't want to break his line, that's the big thing.
And I'm not using my drag, I'm just letting it free spool backwards.
Yeah, you can lose your good jigs here this way.
I'm not going to do anything until he gets up in the hole. There he is. Okay, there we go. And there it is. Right out of the hole there. That's probably a little smaller. We'll see. Yeah. We don't know what we're going to do with that yet. Roger, do you? We're going to probably... We'll probably keep it.
I think we might have to. I see he's bleeding already from the gills.
He's bleeding. So if he's bleeding, we're going to keep him no matter what the size. We don't want to put back a dead fish. So, well, there's another one right out of the fish house. We're not doing too good on perch yet, but we got a whole afternoon left yet. And in the afternoon, sometimes they'll come in schools and they'll start biting. So hopefully. But it's fishing. Yet another flag was off. And this is about 2 o'clock in the afternoon. We still haven't hit the perch yet. He just turned around the area, but we sure hit the northern here.
Nice perch.
Here's this is about a 11 inch perch. We actually caught it on a tip up. And what I did is I took a hook and put about 4 minnows on it, 4 small perch minnows. And that's the result of it right there. So, nice size perch. I know that they're in the lake anyway. The problem is they just aren't really white yet. Okay, we got another northern here. We're fishing perch, but again, the northerns are biting today, and here's Roger with another one on a tip-up. We got out about 100 feet from the house, and they got that on a dead minnow. We put a dead minnow down, and it's probably the biggest one we got so far today.
Holy cow.
And it's a fat northern.
Was that
three and a half pounds? Yeah. So there's what you can do with a dead minnow, too.
Yeah.
In a perch lake. And so, been a successful day on northern so far.
So far.
It's always successful when you're out here on a lake like this. So.
Yeah.
Pretty good. Well, you know, we came out here to do some perch fishing. And I was planning on doing a show on tip-upping, but this show is going to cover that pretty well. We've got 4 northerns here. We had a lot of bites. We're not really done yet. It's getting toward the end of the day, but that's the biggest one we got so far, and that's probably close to 4 pounds. And it's just wonderful to have these in an addition. Now we just got a call. We got another flag up, so out we go. Okay, here we go on another one. Hard to say what we got here, not pulling. I'm going to stand up on this one. Taking line out. That's... say with the minnows we got on here, probably could have been a perch. It was taking a lot of line out, but it took a lot of line out here. Probably 30 feet so far. Most of the line on the reel went off, but no fish. So, that's the way it goes with tip-upping.
We had lots of that today.
Yes, we did. Okay, we got one going on here. It's pretty rare to have a perch, but the bobber went down. And we got a perch going here, I think. Yeah, there he goes. Okay, taking line. Okay, here he comes. Oh yeah, that's about a 10 inch perch. That's a good eater right there. And this is what we're after, and we're thinking we haven't had a bite here in quite a while. And so it's getting toward dark. We got about another hour, and therefore we're thinking maybe this is the start of a little bite here, because we haven't had one for quite a while. This was caught on that Swedish pimple that I was telling you about, and I showed you earlier. Kind of a flashy little thing there, and I just tip it with a minnow, and there it is, right there. That's what we're after.
Okay, we got another perch coming up here. Roger's got one coming out, and there you go.
There's a little eater. It's a little smaller, but probably a keeper. You're talking 8 inches there. You know, if you're going to clean 8 or 10, you might as well keep. We're kind of saying that 8 inches or under we're going to throw back, but that's pretty close right there. So had a couple fish in the last few minutes, so things are starting to go an hour before sunset. So if you're out there and you don't have any fish all day long, you never know about that pre-sunset time. That's always a good time for most fish. And this could include perch today. We'll see how it goes.
Well, let's see what we got here. It's pretty small, though. Well, you never know. Oh, no, that's a keeper. Okay. Well, toward that dark time, toward the sunrise, sundown, that's they're starting to show some activity, getting a little more active here. So there's that Swedish pimple again with the one minnow hook to it, and there's another little keeper there. So it's getting toward dark. We got about another half hour until that sun sets, and now they're starting to bite a little bit. So all this time, we've been waiting for this.
This is the end of our day. It's almost sunset. We got another half hour or so. We didn't do real well on perch. We got about 27 keepers here we're going to keep, and then about 4 northerns. Northerns are fairly good size. Basically, this is the end of our backcountry winter perch fishing venture. And good camaraderie, good day. It really doesn't matter how many fish you catch. It was a cold day, something to do. We're out here on a wilderness lake. It's just a great time spent by all. So I thank you for watching and hope you take something up like this. It'd be good for you to get out, cold day like this, you're not doing anything. And remember, keep informed.